Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install PyCharm IDE in your Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now before installing PyCharm IDE, let us first understand what this IDE does. Now, if you are a Python developer or if you want to be a Python developer, then I am going to recommend you a software called PyCharm IDE. So this IDE basically provides you an interface where you can write your Python code and you can do some Python related project easily on this IDE. So for that, all you need to do is you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here just simply type PyCharm download. Yeah, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply click on this download PyCharm. And this will automatically going to redirect you to this official site of JetBrains and you'll be getting this download PyCharm over here. So here if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be getting these two options. One is this professional one, another is the community one. And I'll be showing you how to install PyCharm IDE in your Windows 10 operating system. So we are going to download for Windows. If you want to install it for macOS or for Linux, then you need to simply proceed with these two links. But as I have told, I'll show you for Windows download. So for that, just simply click on this Windows and then just simply click on download button for download. And then you'll be seeing this thank you for downloading PyCharm. So just simply click on the show in folder and you can clearly see our PyCharm community edition is now currently downloading. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this PyCharm 2021.1.3 community version has been rightly downloaded over here. To install, just simply double click on it. You need to just simply click on yes to give administrative privileges and let us first minimize our download directory. And then you'll be seeing this welcome to PyCharm community edition setup wizard. So this is basically your installation wizard. So just simply click on next. And this is going to be your installation destinations, right? And you can clearly see you need to have 931.9 MB of free space in your C directory. And currently the available space size is 222 GB, so that's not a problem for me. So if you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply proceed with this browse button and you can do that. I am going to keep this all default and then just simply click on next. So now under this installation option, let us first check the 64-bit launcher, because I am using 64-bit operating system, so I'd like to also create the 64-bit launcher as a desktop shortcut. I'd also like to add this add launcher directed to path. This is very important, right? And also I'd also like to add this open folder as a project. This is also very important, so that open a folder as an entire project. So for that, you need to just simply check this. And as I have told, it is for Python only. So we save a Python file as a .py. So that's why we are going to check this .py, so that all Python related files get automatically open with this PyCharm IDE. So just simply check all this and then just simply click on next. And they're going to create this JetBrains folder. So just simply keep this all default and then just simply click on install for installation. You can always click on the show details to check how the installation is actually happening at the backend. It will take a couple of minutes. So for which what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing PyCharm IDE. Yeah. So welcome back. And now as you can clearly see, our PyCharm community edition setup has been rightly completed and it's currently telling that whether we want to reboot now or I want to reboot later. So I want to reboot later, that will not create any problem. So you can always reboot it later. So just simply check I want to reboot later and then just simply click on finish. And here as you can clearly see, our PyCharm community edition 2021.1.3 has been rightly installed over here. And our desktop icon has also been created. So just simply double click on it to open our PyCharm community edition. And here, as you can clearly see, our Python community edition has been indirectly launched and is now currently asking whether we'd like to import our PyCharm settings. I don't have previously installed PyCharm in this machine, so what I'll be going to do is just simply click on Do Not Import Settings and then just simply click on OK. And you can clearly see our PyCharm community edition 2021.1 has been indirectly opened, and our program has also been opened. So welcome to PyCharm. So first maximize it and then just simply click on new project to create a new project, right? And in here you need to provide a project name. So let's give a project name as Hello World, and this is going to be your location where your project is going to be saved, and your base interpreter is Python exe. So you need to have Python installed on your machine, but if you don't have, then you can always install Python from here. You'll be getting a download option over here if you haven't installed Python, but I'll be still recommending you to install Python. So for that, I have already made a video on how to install the latest version of Python 3.9.6. I'll be also putting the link in the description, so you can proceed with that link as well. So that's not a problem. So after that, we'll be getting this base interpreter as a python.exe. So just simply check all this and then just simply click on create. And this will automatically going to load your Hello World project that we have just want to create. So right now it's creating a virtual environment, and it's showing the tip of the day, so you can always click on close and you can always check it later. That's not a problem. It might take some time if you're creating project for the first time, so that will you don't need to worry about that and all. So you can clearly see our project has been rightly created over here, and if you just simply click on this run button, you can clearly see this Hi PyCharm, right? So what it's doing is, this is basically your main method. So inside this main method, this print hi is actually getting called, and it will automatically going to went over this print hi over here by passing this PyCharm value in this name variable. So this print is basically an inbuilt function. So by using this print method, what we are doing is, we are just simply printing this hi then PyCharm. So if you just simply change it to, let's say, your name, I am giving my company name, and just simply click on this run button again, you'll be seeing this hi Geeky Script. So hi is here, and the Geeky Script is actually coming from your parameter that you are just passing over here, right? So in this way, you install PyCharm IDE in Windows 10 operating system. I have rightly shown you how to download and install, and then I have also shown you how to create a simple Hello World project in your PyCharm IDE. So that is basically all about this video. I have this website called geekyscape.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do also check our website geekyscape.com. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.